the sexy threshold delusion. Let's talk about your favorite workout, and I guarantee it's Threshold Thursday. It's that comfortably hard 20-minute tempo run. It's the 10K pace intervals. It's the workout where you feel the burn, taste the lactate, and finish feeling like a hero. This is your anaerobic threshold, LT2. It's the red line. It's the sexy, glorious, high-performance metric that every book, blog, and running influencer tells you to raise. You are obsessed with it. And this obsession is precisely why you are stuck. You've spent years pushing your LT2, building a magnificent penthouse in the sky, but you've built it on a foundation of wet sand. You have completely, utterly, and foolishly ignored the other threshold, the boring one, the one that doesn't get a glamorous name. It's the aerobic threshold, LT1. And here is the sharpest truth you will hear this year. Your anaerobic threshold, LT2, dictates your 10K potential, but your aerobic threshold, LT1, dictates your entire endurance life. It is the single most important, most trainable, and most criminally underrated metric for any runner aiming for a half marathon, marathon, or beyond. By ignoring it, you are not just leaving time on the table, you are actively choosing to be a sugar-burning, inefficient runner, guaranteeing that you will hit the wall in every single endurance event you attempt. The science, the two gates in your physiology. To understand this, you must stop thinking of zones and start thinking of gates. Your physiology has two critical lactate turning points. Gate number one, the aerobic threshold, LT1. This is the first gate. What it is, the point where your blood lactate first rises above its resting baseline, e.g. from 1.0 millimoles per liter to 1.5 millimoles per liter. What it means, this is the exact point where your purely aerobic, fat-burning type 1, slow-twitch fibers, can no longer handle 100% of the workload. To help out, your brain just begins to recruit a few type 2A, fast-twitch fibers, the fuel. You are still burning mostly fat, but you've just started to turn on the glycogen sugar spigot. Lactate is still being cleared easily. This is your all-day pace. Gate number two, the anaerobic threshold, LT2. The sexy one. This is the second gate. What it is. The point where lactate production massively outstrives your body's ability to clear it. Lactate floods the system. What it means, your brain is now recruiting a huge number of type 2, a fast twitch fibers. You are in a controlled burn. This is your 1 hour race pace, your threshold. The fuel, you are now burning almost exclusively glycogen. This is a high-cost, high-power state. The black hole, where 90% of runners go to die. The problem is not LT1 or LT2. The problem is the massive, toxic no-man's land between them. This is the gray zone. This is the black hole of training, and this is where you live. The sabotage of medium hard. Your easy runs are not easy. You go out for an 8K run. You think you're building your base. But you're running at a medium effort. You're breathing a little hard. You're sweating. It feels productive. In reality, you are running just above your LT1. You are deep in the gray zone. This is the single worst way to train. Here is what you are doing to your body. You are not building your aerobic base. The easy run is supposed to be the primary stimulus for mitochondrial biogenesis, building more and bigger power plants in your muscles, and capillarization. More blood vessels. This adaptation is maximized below LT1. By running above it, you're creating too much stress and blunting this signal. You are burning the wrong fuel. You are teaching your body to be a sugar burner. Instead of training your type 1 fibers to be more efficient at burning fat, you are forcing them to burn glycogen. You are making yourself less efficient and more dependent on carbohydrates. This is a one-way ticket to hitting the wall. You accumulate junk fatigue. This gray zone effort is not easy enough for recovery, but not hard enough for adaptation. You are just getting medium tired. This junk fatigue accumulates, and when Threshold Thursday, your real LT2 workout arrives, you are too tired to actually hit your paces. You are creating a hollow runner. Your easy runs are too hard, and your hard runs are too soft. You are compressing your entire training into one useless medium effort blurb. You have no high gear and you have no low gear. You are a jack of all trades, master of none. You have no endurance base and you have no top end speed. all because you refuse to run truly easy. The gospel of LT1, how to build a monster. So what happens when you check your ego at the door and start respecting your aerobic threshold? You build a monster of a diesel engine. The 80-20 rule is not a suggestion. It's physiology. When coaches talk about polarized training, or 80-20, they are not guessing. They are talking about LT1, that 80% of easy, voluminous training must be done below your aerobic threshold, LT1. This is what happens when you do. You become a fat-burning machine. By spending hours below LT1, you force your body to adapt. Your type 1 fibers become unbelievably efficient at metabolizing fat for fuel. A marathon is a 42.2 kilometer race, and you only have approximately 90 minutes of glycogen in your tank. The only way to win is to spare that glycogen. You do this by becoming a fat-burning machine. This is your only defense against the wall. You build a mitochondrial factory. This low-intensity, high-volume work is the single greatest signal for your body to build more mitochondria. More mitochondria equals more factories that can burn fat and clear lactate. You push LT1 from below. Here is the secret. As your aerobic system becomes more efficient, your body can handle more work before it needs to recruit those type 2 fibers. Your LT1 moves to a faster pace. Week 1. Your LT1 is at 6 kilometers per hour. Anything faster is gray zone. Week 12. After 11 weeks of true zone 2 training, your LT1 is now at 530 kilometers per hour. This is free speed. Your all-day pace is now 30 seconds per kilometer faster. Your marathon pace just dropped by 20 plus minutes. And you did it by running slow. You can finally go hard. Because 80% of your training is truly easy and aerobic, you are no longer carrying junk fatigue. When it's time for your one LT2 workout of the week, you are fresh, powerful, and can actually hit the paces required to stimulate real adaptation at the top end. You are building your foundation of solid granite. Now you can build your penthouse. But it feels too slow. Yes, it will. If you are a 330 marathoner, your LT1, true aerobic pace, is likely slower than 6 minutes per kilometer, 9 minutes 40 seconds per mile. It will feel embarrassingly slow. Your ego will hate it. Your GPS watch will judge you. Your ego is what is keeping you slow. How do you find it? The gold standard, a lab test. We put you on a treadmill and actually measure your blood lactate as the speed increases. This gives us the exact heart rate and pace for your LT1. The field test, MAF 180, a common but not perfect proxy. 180 minus your age. This is the ceiling of your aerobic heart rate. The nasal breathing test. Can you run for 10 minutes breathing only through your nose? If you can't, you are above your LT1. The RPE test. It should feel like a 2 to 3 out of 10. It should feel like you could do it for 12 hours. It is not a conversational pace. A conversation should be effortless. Your job as an endurance athlete is not to run medium hard. Your job is to make your easy runs truly easy and your hard runs truly hard. And the dividing line for easy is the aerobic threshold. It is the king of all metrics, and you have been ignoring it. You are not a tough runner. You are an inefficient one. You've just read the science. Your obsession with the burn of LT2 and your addiction to the gray zone is the very thing holding you back. You are a sugar burner in a fat-burning sport. You are a penthouse with no foundation. You are running with a handbrake on. But this is counterintuitive. It takes discipline and courage to run truly slow. It takes confidence to ignore what everyone else is doing in the medium lane. This is where science beats feel. This is where a plan beats junk miles. You can keep guessing, keep living in the gray zone, and keep hitting the wall. Or you can finally find out where your true aerobic threshold is and build a foundation so massive that your old PRs look like a warm-up. Are you ready to stop training in the black hole? Are you ready to become a fat-burning endurance machine? If you're ready to build a real foundation, send me a message today. Running Coach Demetris, MSc in Sports Science. Your running journey powered by science.